You may be surprised looking at today's topic. No, there is no mistake. Yes, IT is supposed to be an enabler, but today's topic is why IT is a disabler. Last 15 years, I have been doing user advocacy. What does that mean? How to make sure users use the technology which IT is giving them. And that's a big problem. So whatever I'm going to talk about in this podcast is primarily in the context of Microsoft 365 platform. That's my specialization. So why am I saying IT as a disabler? Well, IT's responsibility is what? You know that. Get the technology, deploy it, manage it, release it to users and let them use it. Very good. Problem in the context of offices, we have no direct contact with users. We give them the tools and they use it the way they want. And that's where the problem is. I'll give you a simplest of examples. In Microsoft 365, you have so many apps. I have been doing sessions for hundreds of customers, thousands of customers. Not a single customer has all these apps enabled. Now you will ask why. Microsoft has given all the apps. There's no harm in using them, but instead of teaching all the users what these apps are about and how to use them, somehow the IT ecosystem disables half of them. Okay, let's not talk about many apps, let's talk about one app. Excel, very commonly used. You don't have to teach it to people, they just use it. Excel is misused for data entry because we send files as attachments, people fill data, then I get the files, copy paste. It's boring, irritating, time consuming and error prone. The correct way of doing data entry is not to use Excel for data entry. We should use lists. Why lists? Because it has many more data types, much better validation. You're not sending a file at all. You're just sending a link. And when people enter data, they can see only their own data. But when you log in, you see all the data. No copy paste, no files, only link. And then analysis can still happen in Excel and Power BI. So best of both worlds. Now, what is wrong with this? It's good from whichever angle you look at. But I know customers, many of them, where list is disabled. Show me the logic. Now, what is list, by the way? As a technical person, you know, list is a fundamental unit of SharePoint. And Teams is based on SharePoint. So now you will say that in the customer who have a disabled list, SharePoint and Teams also must be disabled. No. Both of them are enabled. So why disable list? Absolutely no logic. Nobody is really thinking of anything, randomly taking decisions. That's what I mean, IT as a disabler. So much of opportunity lost because of lack of clarity, lack of little bit of thinking, and lack of empathy about users. In fact, the commonest joke is, why do we call them end users? Because their life has ended. Khatam ho gaya. There is no hope only. Now, there is a team, hopefully, called End User Computing, EUC it is called. Do they actually talk to end users and get their job done better? No, they are end user computing means they are managing endpoints and office deployment and patches. That's all. It's still an IT person. So the thing I'm trying to tell you about is even though you are an IT person, when it comes to using the office platform, you're not behaving like an IT person. You're like any other user. So you don't have to put yourself in their shoes. You're already in those shoes. You think, how am I using the Office platform the same way users are using? So now you can think of areas of improvement. You don't have to wait for users to come to you. And that's the thought process. That's the proactivity which I expect from IT teams. Security is nowadays a separate team, and that's another disaster. Yes, we want security, but we don't want a very secure business where people can't work. Does that make any sense? Extremely secure with no work. But that's exactly what happens. I'll give you the classic example during and after COVID. Earlier it was all work from home, now it's hybrid. Okay, now where are my files? My files are on OneDrive. Where am I sitting? At home, or I am on field. What device am I using? My laptop or my mobile phone. And what is the IT policy? Oh, I can't access OneDrive now. Now, what is the point in having my official files on official OneDrive when I can't access them when I need them? It does not have any logical foundation at all. Now the logic is, oh, this is a person-owned device, I don't know which network, but then I'm at a customer place, I need that file there. Now I don't have it, what am I going to do? I'll say this OneDrive is a problem, let me always store the files on local drive. Now that OneDrive for which you are paying, people stop using it, if at all they had started using it because of this problem. Now people are storing files on local drive, and because local drive has all sorts of problems, there is no backup. If I share file with someone, I'm going to send a copy. So we are back to 30 years back. So now where are we? We regressed by a decade. Where is the cloud benefit gone? So what is the solution here? Of course there is a solution. You go to SharePoint, SharePoint admin, and there is a setting in case SharePoint, which is also OneDrive, being accessed from an unmanaged device, which we assume is not secure. We want security, so we don't want people to download files, correct? But we want people to work also. So unmanaged device allow people to work on OneDrive only on browser-based editing. Now what is the benefit? People are getting their work done and security is maintained. That's what I mean. Instead of disabling, try to find a balance between productivity and whatever you are trying to disable. 100% there is a solution. So find the right balance between IT objectives and business needs. Remember, IT is 2-3% of total population. Rest of it is business users. They are the ones doing business. They are the ones getting revenue. They are the ones paying everyone's salary. So they are our internal customers as well. We know that, but we don't treat them like a customer. Start doing that and you will see the impact. So now here is a thought process and a call to action. Look at all the Microsoft 365 apps. Proactively look at what people are doing and where you can add value. I know it may not be a part of your job, but trust me, you start doing it, you will progress as a person in your career and you will be adding value to business, and it will be acknowledged by users as well as management. And the best place to start is security, compliance and productivity together. I'm going to give you a list of topics. I'm not going to discuss those in details. If you want me to discuss those in details, put it in comments. I'll be happy to create separate videos on those. So these are topics where you can improve security, improve IT efficiency, as well as business efficiency. Look at them, implement them, and life is better. And now IT is an enabler rather than a disabler. So if you like this podcast, this is not the only one. I have a series of podcasts. Have a look at it and do give me ideas about similar topics which are of your interest, and share it with your colleagues and other IT people, because I want this thought process to be broad-based, everyone to understand it, because everyone is going to benefit from it. So that is it for now. Thank you.